I might have to use the webcam audio. Hold on, guys. Hold on.
Oh, farts. God damn it. Let me see if I can get this fixed, guys. Hang on. Man, I don't want to have to use the webcam audio. I'm going to try quitting out of OBS and relaunching it. It's probably going to kill the stream, but I'll bring the stream right back. Be right back.
All right. Now we've got audio. But what I don't know is if you guys are still here. Technical issues. What's up, everybody? My name's Aaron Ciotti. Everybody calls me Ciotti. You can call me Crazy Hair Guy. Audio is now working. Hold on. I gotta kill the webcam. Whoops. Wait, no, that was right. Okay. Killed the webcam. Don't know if anybody's still here, though. Let me hit a button or two, and in theory, all will be better. Let's see here. All right. Hey, look at that. The stream stayed up. Well, that's pretty cool. That's good to know. Maybe because I shut OBS down so quick. Well, that's a really good thing. I was pretty sure that if I ever had to quit OBS, it would chonk the entire stream. That's pretty cool. $2 super chat from, I believe it was Eric. We're going to get our decased GoPro fund going here. Let me just move that on top there. And $2 becomes $4. Thank you, Eric. I think it was Eric. Thank you, whoever it was. All right. So I called everybody's names out, but then the thing happened. So 360 Vlogger is here. Aloe Vera is here. Oh, no. Aloha Vera. Nice. Austin Hood is here. Athix FPV. Aztec Joe FPV. Aza Ace Man. Billy D FPV. B-Man 80. Bread Vogel Slang. Cement Kid. Sean Wang. Chris Comeo. Chris Mel FPV. Droney Droid. Ella Hawk. Eric Allen, Eric Farmer, Experimental RC, Felix FPV, Flying Umbrella FPV, Frank Nichols, Gapman FPV, Gav, Grey Dogs FPV, Jafar Zaidi, James Leo, Jamie Holberg, J. Martell 68, John Dunn, Jonathan King, Joseph Andriani, Josh, Justin French, Carbon Cage, FPV, KD2RDH, Larry Keith, Keith Drones, Kimbo, Love Drummer, Mick Mondo, FPV, Mr. Sprinkles, Nathaniel LaBouffe, Next Gate Seeker, and Ramos 86. Okay, what was that? Okiode Arelua. I almost got it. Kind of. I probably massacred it. Parts for Brent Toys, Pedro Tomei, Pros 71 Full, Rob's FPV, Rob Axelson, Robbie B, Seth McLean, Solo FPV, Speedy Turtle, Steven Steinbaker, Steve O 43068. The 17th floor, the GST tip. Oh no. The GS tip. Tiago Ramos, Todd, Tommy Lou, Victor Gonzalez, Will FPV, Almond Flights, and Euro FPV. What's going on, folks? Whew! I'm all sweaty from having to do that twice. Look at this nonsense. Yikes. Whoever can figure out what this shirt is from doesn't get anything other than my. I'll be very impressed. So there you go. I won't give you any suggestions. That's not the word. Tips. That's the word. Stuck in Trees was the first one to get here, but he had to go to sleep. So he'll watch this tomorrow. He'll hear his name and get excited. Love Drummer, what's up to you? Eric Allen, what's up to you? Love Drummer and Eric Allen and then Carbon Cage all tagged me. And that's what you need to do if you want me to see your comment, because the chat goes a little too fast for me to catch everything. And I also want you guys to talk amongst yourselves. The Ciotti Collective is the group of folks here who know just as much as one another, and we like to take advantage of that. I'm the guy with the camera pointed at me, but I'm not necessarily the smartest guy in the room, and that's okay. So talk amongst yourselves in the chat. If somebody gives you an answer in the chat, trust them. If you don't trust them for whatever reason, tag me, and I'll look at it, and I'll give you my impression. All you got to do to tag me is type Ciotti FPV. It says it right down here. CIOTTIFPV. No spaces. You don't even need an at tag. Just type Ciotti FPV. It'll light up an orange for me, and then I will read your question. Just like Eric Allen's, he asked me how my day was going and what was up. Day's going all right. Weird day, if I'm honest. Carbon Cage says, hey, fucker. Y'all Man Flight says, you're a dork. You guys are okay. It's just attack the idiot with the camera pointed at him day. Flying in Braille says, what's up? Speedy Turtle. Oh, God. YouTube, really? Okay. Well, all right. I just lost half the comments because YouTube sucks balls. so the highest up comment that I've got is Frank Nichols saying silent film, and then Experimental RC saying no sound. So if you tag me above that, you're gonna have to re-tag me. It's totally fine. Eric Allen with $2 calling me out on the no audio. Gapman then tagged me and said no sound. Scrolling down. Josh, thank you for the warning. Love Drummer, thank you for the warning. All you guys, thank you for the warnings. Y'all Man Flights, how long does it take to read that there's no sound? It takes a long time. And then Frank Nichols saying, woot, we hear you. All right, cool. So we're somewhat caught up here. Going. Scroll. Now we've only got 20 minutes before the giveaways. God damn, we got to really hurry. Gapman FPV says, good. Larry says, mime live stream, brilliant. Scrolling. Here we go. Frank Nicholas says, echo. That was probably when both mics were on. There's probably no echo now. Scroll. Frank Nichols, echo-2x mics, echo. Echo better be gone by now. Jesus. Woot, it works again, Frank Nichols says. Perfect. Double makes. Okay, good. So it looks like we're good. Solo says, what's good? Love Drummer says, here. Frank Nichols says, 82x viewers. KD2RDH Larry says, I'm not here. Yo-Man says, you're good now. Athix says, hey. Rob Axelson says, don't touch anything. Yo-Man Flight says, now say my name. Too late. I already said it a couple times. Scroll. Rob Axelson, let's do this again. Ciotti FPV, Octopus FPV now. Hello, ladies. Dirt. Wow, 87. Dude, awesome. I'm glad that we're doing such a big giveaway tonight. Tonight's giveaway is 3 frames for all the Patreon folks. Here's how the giveaways work. You go over to my Patreon page, which is linked down below. I'm not pointing at the text. I'm pointing down below the text in the description field. There's a link to my Patreon page. There are a bunch of different tiers. The $3 tiers get you access to the Patreon page. It gets you over on Discord, which is fun. And you just become a super awesome person that supports other awesome people. I just called myself an awesome people. That's pretty cool. I usually call myself a dick. So yeah, $3 gets you in the door. All kinds of good content over there on Patreon. I promise it'll be worth $3 a month, which is like 10 cents a day. Come on now. Get that piggy bank out. You got 10 cents a day. I know you do. The $5, $10, $20, and $30 tiers are where the giveaways come in. The reason that I do the giveaways over on Patreon is so that you don't have to be here to get in on them. I don't want to punish people that work late nights, Monday nights. I mean, it's not even that late. But you guys know what I'm saying, right? So, yeah, everything is done through Patreon so that it's the most fair for everybody. So that, you know, if you want to get in on it, you can. And then I message you if you've won and eventually mail it out. I say eventually because I'm the worst at mailing stuff. But I'm only, like, 2 weeks behind right now. So, ha! Eat that. Oh, it is Karateka. Good going, Metal Dirt Skin. I've worn this shirt before, and it has been guessed before. Yeah, I actually played Karateka on Apple, old Apple computers. I never had it for Nintendo. This is a game that my father and I used to play on Apple, and we liked it because it was so fucking impossible. It was just a game that, like, you just kind of couldn't beat. It was so incredibly difficult. All right, more scrolling. Oh, wait, no, giveaways. Yeah, so the $5 tier is Tiny Whoop and toothpick stuff. For example, tonight it's a TP3 frame. The $10 a month tier, and for the record, this gets you entered on a month's worth of giveaways. So every Monday night you're going to get entered in a giveaway. And Patreon is monthly, so $5 for 4 giveaways, $10 for 4 giveaways, $20 for 4 giveaways. $10 tier is 3-inch micro brushless stuff, heavier stuff, kind of like this Armaton Tadpole. And then the $20 a month tier is for 5-inch stuff, like this X-Hover race frame. It's a Vanover race frame. And then we always do, for the folks that just can't or don't want to do the Patreon thing, even though Patreon is amazing, and I really recommend you guys head over there. There are some awesome people doing some awesome shit, and they need all of our help. So give them a couple bucks a month, and then they can survive and do more cool shit. what was I saying? Oh, yeah, $20 tier, 5-inch stuff. This way, also, if you only have Tiny Whoops, you can only enter the Tiny Whoops tier, right? But if you've got a Tiny Whoop, a toothpick, a 3-inch microbrushes, and a 5-inch rig, and you really want to support me, there's a $30 tier that'll get you entered into all the giveaways all the time forever until the dawn of time. And you can win lots of stuff and just profit. Yeah, it puts you in all three of the giveaways every week, so you'll be put into 12 giveaways a month. Those people that do that win all kinds of stuff, and I find myself shipping to the same, like, 20 or 30 people, but hey, they're the ones that are doing 30 a month to support your boy, the skinniest fella you've ever seen. You guys hanging out is plenty of thanks. Love you guys stopping by. Enough of the nonsense. Let's dive into the questions. Scroll, scroll, scroll. Where are the questions? Yoman Flight says, you never sent me the link. What link? I don't know what link, brother. Let me know, and I will hopefully send it to you. Cement Kid says, Kung Fu Nintendo. All right, bunch of people. It looks like Chris Comeo is the first one to call out Karateka. And what's interesting about that is Chris Comeo, I don't think you're a regular here, so I don't think you're one of these cheating bastards that just remember it from the last time I asked. So, good on you, brother. Good on you. Who knew this from Apple, though? That's what I really want to know. We all had Nintendos, but who knew this from OG Apple 2GS computers? That's the important part. Lavalimp is on, Jafar. Scrolling, scrolling, scrolling. Hey, look at that. Chris Comeo, you knew it from Apple IIe. All right, Chris definitely knew it because he knows what an Apple IIe is. And not many people are nerdy enough to know what an Apple IIe is. Although, knowing our audience, it's probably half the people in the chat that know what an Apple IIe is. Seth McLean says, few of us want to see you run the name for a third time. Not going to happen. As a matter of fact, balls, I don't have water in here. That's okay. I'll get it later. Okay, YouTube did the thing where it zipped me to the bottom. Now I got to scroll back up to the top. You motherfucker, you. Hey, here we go. Keith Drone says, GoPro 7 or 8? 8. it's just as fragile, and it's got better features. So, yeah, just get the 8. if anybody doesn't know, the GoPro Heroes are the complete opposite of the GoPro Session 5 in that they're not durable, and they explode all the time. And it ends up costing you a fortune taking them back to Best Buy over and over again to get them replaced. Almost sounds like I've done it 6 or 7 times now. So yeah, I no longer fly the Heroes freestyle. I will literally pay whatever the Session 5s are selling for. Last I saw, they were up at like $160, $170 on eBay. I will gladly pay. I'll pay $200 for a Session 5 because I can smash that Session 5 70, 80, 90 times before it fails. Whereas the Heroes, a bunch of them died on the first crash, and I would typically fly a little bit more cautious when I had the Heroes on, so like, not durable at all. Not even a little bit durable. And not to mention, I had them in a big, beefy mount. Look at this big, beautiful BMC 3D mount that I had them in. Look at all this protection around here. All this nice TPU so that, you know, when you smash on the GoPro, there's a lot of squishy TPU to take up as much of the hit as possible before the hard GoPro slammed into anything, right? Like, I gave it all the chance that I... This is a 25-gram mount. I did not like running a mount that was this heavy, but I can't afford to pay $50 every time I go fly in with the Heroes just imploding every time you brush up against a branch. Yeah. Droidy Droid says, your shirt is NES Kung Fu Master versus Duck Hunt. It's not Duck Hunt. It's just Karateka. It's not NES Kung Fu Master. It's not Duck Hunt. But I can see how you can you would connect the two. But yeah, this is a game called Karateka. Scrolling down. Chris Comeo, there's where he called out Karateka. License to Drive said, T-shirt is IK Plus. What's IK Plus? Jonathan King said, any experiences with the HGLRC Zeus Z475? Just ordered their 20x20 stack. Jonathan King, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but I am extremely anti-HGLRC. I have had nothing but bad experiences with HGLRC electronics. The majority of their stuff for me has just not worked right out of the box. And then the rest of it failed either on the first battery or within one or two batteries. The original Zeus was definitely a train wreck, but I know that they have released an updated Zeus, and I hope it's not as much of a train wreck, but I swore off HGLRC a long time ago. I think on the 5th or 6th electronic component of theirs to just fail right away, I just said, you know what, A, I can't afford this, B, I'm going to quit this hobby if I buy one more thing and it catches on fire. So yeah, personally, horrible experiences with HGRC. I hope to hell that you have a better experience. My recommendation though to you is going to be, well, I hope to hell that you bought it from somewhere where you can return it, because my recommendation would be that as soon as you get it in, don't open it. Contact whoever you bought it from and ask them if you can return it. Just say, like, I bought the wrong thing. There's plenty of other stuff out there that doesn't catch on fire from, you know, the second that you look at it. Yeah, lots and lots of good stuff down below in the description. I have listed out all the gear that I personally fly and have used hard over the last 3 years, and it has held up. So yeah, go with the stuff down in my description. It'll actually probably be cheaper. HGLRC isn't even all that cheap anymore, and it'll work for you. So there you go. If you can't return it, I'm sorry again to be the bearer of bad news, but I don't know, maybe sell it to a friend that you don't like. Don't do that. That's a terrible idea. Okay. Larry says, never ask him about HGLRC. Trust me. Rob Axison says, discovered not to try to activate the DVR in my Fat Shark goggles while flying over water. Had to bring it back line of sight. Had a small heart attack. Oh. Rob went to the menu. Hey man, stuff like that, like when stuff like that happens and you have to bring it back line of sight, that's real good practice, man. That's real good, like don't panic practice, right? Like teaching yourself not to freak out, and also good line of sight practice of like, shit, am I tail in? Am I nose in? What the hell am I? That's gnarly that you got it back, man. A lot of people would have lost it in the drink. Metal Dirtskin, someone else got it first, but remember Prince of Persia on DOS. Oh my God. It's funny. The developer of Karateka, Prince of Persia was a big fuck, what's the word? Influence on him. And there was some technical thing that you couldn't do in Prince of Persia. I think it was like jump and kick or something like that, but there was some technical hurdle that Prince of Persia couldn't figure out that this dude did figure out in Karateka, and it was like, oh my God. Yeah, so in case anybody needs to know my nerd credentials, there you go. Aethix FPV needs a TPU. Words are hard. Needs the TP3 frame. There it is. Okay, Aethix, I'll be pulling for you. I'll cross my fingers behind my back and hope that you win. Eric Farmer says that TP is 2.5 inch. By the way, is it? No, it's not. It says TP3. TP3. You guys can't read it, but it does. Three. Ha! I did a giveaway at one point for a TP 2.5, but that thing is long gone. Yaw Man Flight says, once I get my unemployment, I'm in. Nice. I'm in the same situation, Yaw Man. Off Axis FPV says, I'm here, but I can't hear you. I muted you. Thanks, Off Axis. Kaiser Soze says, nice shirt. What is it? I think you should know by now, but if you still don't, ask me again, Kaiser. Awesome name, by the way. I think I saw someone ask if it's a wig. No, Larry, it's not a wig. Here, I'll prove it. Look at that. See? My whole head moves. I wish it was a wig, because then I could take this goddamn forest on top of my head that makes me hot as shit off sometimes. Yawman says, did you check out that frame? I sent the link. Probably not, Yawman. I had big plans for all this stuff that I wanted to get done today. But instead, my cat, little Harold Potter, was curled up in a ball on the bed, and we just put new sheets on, and I may or may not have just laid there and like put my hand on him and fallen asleep for many hours in the middle of the day. Seth McLean says session versus the RunCam Orange. For sure the session. My RunCam Box 5, which I'm assuming is what you mean by RunCam Orange, it is oversaturated and incredibly not durable. Mine, the case broke on mine in the very first, not even hard at all crash. And then I landed in a puddle. And it shut off, and it did come back eventually, but it's not waterproof either. Yeah, it's not cheap enough. You can still buy Session 5s on eBay for a sane amount of money, and it outperforms the RunCam Box 5 in pretty much every way. Once the Session 5s go away, maybe if there's a way of getting a Shurion protection on it, like for example, if they sell it on Amazon, RunCam Box 5. Hey, they do. So they sell it on Amazon, which is great. Oh my God, $130. Get the fuck out of town. Definitely not for $130. But you can get Asurion protection on it, and that's important. The eBay warranty thing that you can get is through Square Trade, and even though it looks like it covers from the stuff that they say about their Square Trade warranty, even though you'll think that it covers physical damage, it does not. Like, confirmed 100%, Square Trade does not cover physical damage, unless you buy something brand new from them. Amazon has Asurion. And even if it's refurbished, like for a little while they well, for a long time they had refurbished GoPro Session 5s on Amazon. The Asurion does cover physical damage. So it would also cover physical damage on this Runcam Box 5. The problem is going to be it's going to break constantly, so it's constantly going to be in the mail being returned. And for $130, that's crackhead. I don't know what else to say. But $130 is way, 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 way too much money. I will buy Session 5s and crash them 100 times before they fail all day, every day over this Box 5 with the Asurion coverage. So until the Session 5s are well and truly gone forever, big fat no from me on the Runcam 5 box. I really wanted to love it. I really, really did. But the case broke immediately. Like, immediately. Runcam apparently spent a shitload of money to make the Sessions very durable. Did I say Runcam? I meant to say GoPro. Runcam doesn't have that kind of money to do that sort of R&D. So, yeah. I can't blame them for having a camera that explodes when you crash, because most cameras explode when you crash. It's just that GoPro happened to make the Session 5 this magical unicorn farting dust shitball. Not shitball, that's mean. But yeah, unicorn farts, dust, all that good stuff. Great question though, Seth. Athic says, for the durability test for everything, you're the durability test for everything. Yes, I am. If you need something durability tested, send it to me, and I will gladly smash the balls out of it. Yo-Man Flight says, I'm about to go 3D. Wish me luck. I hope this Ditone can pull it off. I think anything can pretty much pull it off by now, right? Good luck, though. You're going to need it. Flying 3D is hard as shit. 10:29, 1 minute until we start talking about doing the giveaways. Jonathan King says, Rezoos. Well, that sucks. Thank you for your input. Fingers crossed. This isn't a train wreck. Did you get it from Rezoos, Jonathan King? Even if you don't think that they'll return it, I would at least shoot him a message and say, like, hey, I accidentally bought the wrong thing. Can I return this? Or maybe it's fine. Maybe the HGLRC stuff is now fine and they learned their lesson. I haven't heard any good things about any other stuff. I haven't heard any bad things lately either. So that's why I'm saying maybe it's fine. But yeah, I don't know. Rob Oxison says, curious to see how the Insta360 Go stands up to your smashing. He said test bench, but I say smashing. Yeah, I did the best thing I possibly could for its durability, and I left it in my buddy Patrick's car by accident last time we were flying. So far so good. It's very durable thus far. I've only flown it like twice. Cement Kid is very coolly sending me some 3D printed stuff, one of which is a lens protector and a little top protector thing that hopefully will make it not explode. Rob says his flew off during flight and smeared across the asphalt, but it survived. I had mine come out as well. The second battery, I think, that I flew it with, I, of course, crashed into a tree, and it went flying and got a little scratched up, but it did survive. So I did get it from Amazon, though, with the Asurion protection, so when I do smash it to hell, I'll get another one for $15 or whatever it costs for the Asurion protection. Scrolling. It is giveaway time, but I am trying to get caught up on the chat somewhat, because at the end of the giveaways, when I go back to the chat, it has always pushed stuff off the end of the map, and I can't read it anymore. Ooh, I'm almost caught up. Carbon Cage FPV, guys in Bardwell chat reckon I should break off or glue my VTX buttons to avoid accidental pressing from crashes or battery strap. Yeah, I kind of do the same thing. I take an X-Acto knife, and I just shave the exposed part of the button off. So, like, you know, the buttons on the VTX are kind of like this. You know, there's a flat silver part, and then there's the actual plastic button. So if you just shave it, just shave the exposed outer part off, it's super simple with an X-Acto knife, you can still poke the button, right? Because the bottom part of the plastic is still there. So you can still take a tool and push in on the, you know, on the plastic part of the button that's inside the silver metal bastard. So if you need it, you can still push the button, but the reason I do it is because I shrink wrap my VTXs, and the shrink wrap pulls, and it pulls, it pushes the button, right, and it holds the button down forever. So you can either shave the button off, that's the quickest and the easiest way, or you can shrink wrap it and then sit there and fuck with the shrink wrap, which I've done once or twice on the stream. It works, but it's annoying and it takes a long time, and I never end up using the button anyway because Smart Audio. So, yeah, I'm a big fan of that. License to Drive says, Prince of Persia's characters were made with rotoscoping. Maybe that had something to do with it. The guy who made Karateka has a book out about the making of Karateka that's supposedly really good. It's in my it's been on my wish list for about 10 years. It's one of those things that every time I'm doing an order, I'm like, oh yeah, I'll finally get that. And I add it to the cart, and then I add a bunch of other shit, and then I'm like, all right, let me check out. And the cart is like $700. I'm like, okay, let's go through the cart and take all the shit off that I don't need. And every time I take the book off. Yawman Flight says, Caddx Dolphin, man, it's a good starter. I have a Caddx Dolphin somewhere. Is that the one that's in my bag? Is that this one? Yeah, look at that, Caddx Dolphin. I like the, I hate to admit it, but I think I like the Caddx Dolphin a little bit better than the Box 5, mainly because the case just, I don't know, something about the case just strikes me that it's going to last longer. I don't know. Maybe not. I haven't bashed either one of them hard enough to fully break them, but we'll see. Metal Dirt Skin, you've been doing any more with the Insta360 Go? I have one and curious about your thoughts. I really like it so far. I haven't used it much. It's been stuck in Patrick's car for half the time that I've owned it. But I will get it back. CJ James says, I've heard reviews that are Shure is terrible and will screw you. I've been wondering about the GoPro insurance before I buy one. Big Willy FPV is our resident Asurion tester. He got a Session 5, I think it was, from Amazon with Asurion, sent it back, and he said it was like, here's your money. Like, they were totally cool. Mike Bergman, Kitten is doing great, man. He's, well, I mean, as great as you can be with a ruined pancreas. But, yeah, the regimen of drugs and special food and all the different things that we do to keep him alive has been working for about the last year. It's about a year ago that he got super sick, and we almost lost him. But yeah, it's been good for, he's been totally good for like the last 8 or so months. There were a scary couple months. A lot of you guys might remember that, since, as I found out recently, I've been streaming for over a year, which is crazy. Yeah, he's been good. We're down to 68. No surprises. Let's get the giveaways going. I think I'm in a good spot in the chat where we'll be okay. All right. Mark Kunoff, believe it or not, the Emacs Eco 1404s are not all that notchy. They're somewhere in the middle. I have a stream from 2 weeks ago called like Testing Motor Notchiness. Watch that stream. The 1404s are in that stream, and you will literally get to see 280 frame per second, 270 frame per, I forget what it is, video of how notchy those 1404s are compared to some of the other motors that are actually notchy. I've had good luck with those Eco 1404s on the Tiny Trainer. They fly fine. I wouldn't call them smooth, but they're not notchy enough to really cause issues with the gyro. So there you go. Larry, why is he going to blow his brains out if he watches that stream? I thought that was a good stream. Okay. Oh, wait. Okay. So another perk of Patreon is when I take 3 to 4 to 5 minutes to put everybody on the wheel, I grab somebody from the Patron Pilot Spotlight thread that's over there that every one of you guys, if you're patrons, you should post your YouTube channel in. Yeah, we play one of their most recent videos, which we're going to do right now. God damn it, I closed the... No, I didn't. There it is. I left it open. All right, cool. So last time, we played someone's video. And I don't remember who it was. It was either Krunked. I think it was Krunked. Pretty sure it was Krunked. So we're going to go Shane Duggar this week. Unless we did Shane Duggar last week. Anybody remember? Anybody? Bueller? I'm pretty sure it was Krunked last week. So we're going to go Shane Duggar this week. Here you guys go. I'm pulling up his channel. Shane, you're about to be e-famous. You're about to be as e-famous as I can muster, my man. We're going to go 3 days ago. He did some Windy Stadium dives. I like it already. All right, here we go. We're going to click play. 3 minutes and 53 seconds. That should be enough time for me to get everybody on the wheels. So I will be back. Wait, hold on. In case I figured out how to do this, if you guys want to join the Patreon page in the first half hour here of the Monday Night Streams to get in on the giveaways, I figured out how to do it. I just have to look at my emails because Patreon sends me an email. So I just looked over my emails and I don't have any Patreon emails. So nobody bit, but that's okay. Everybody that's already a patron, you guys are going to be the ones that get to win. None of you new fuckers will win. Sorry, just kidding. If you're new here, you'll get used to that. I insult you guys a lot. It's you know. Just something I do. Nothing personal. All right, so here comes Shane Duggar. Enjoy, and I'm going to even give you guys the audio. And I'll be back with some wheels that we're going to spin. Thank you. There it be, Shane Duggar getting it done with some micro action. What, Shane, if you're in here, what the hell, what rig is that? So it's at 18 volts, so that's a 5S. That's a 5S, is that a micro? Is that a tiny trainer? Do I see tiny trainer angles on the, wait, it probably says in the, in the description, hold on. let me make sure that the keystroke worked. Yeah, the keystroke worked. Okay, cool. Oh man, Shane, you didn't tell us what it is. Let's post. We're gonna post on Shane's video. What rig is that? 5S? Alright, cool. Everybody follow Shane Duggar. Here comes a link to his channel. If you're a cool person, you'll follow Shane. I didn't even realize that I wasn't subscribed. I am the worst. There's Shane's channel. Go follow him or else. He's one of our wonderful longtime patrons. Very new to the hobby when he got into it, and he's just been learning a ton. And yeah, man, that's what it's all about. All right, I got wheels ready for you guys. Here we go. First up is Thing. Hawk Pro on 5S. There it is. Well, you got a comment on your arms keep loosening up. Yeah, that happened, Shane. Loctite the ever-loving balls out of foam. I have to do the same thing on the glide frame. All right, first up, we've got a TP3. This is from... I'll make you guys suffer through it. Friends of the channel, TweetFPV is the man. He makes... grip tape controller grips for all the different transmitters. Get you some. Tweet FPV. Message him. BMC3D makes excellent TPU. Some of the best, in Joshua Bardwell's opinion. BMC3D. There's Tweet FPV in the chat. Tweet, you giving away a set of the grips for the Super Chat giveaway tonight? There's my sticker. Here's a whole bunch more that I finally got in. I'm not selling them yet, though, because there's some other cool stuff coming. Stay tuned. This one says for rectal use only. This is mine again. Stan FPV makes awesome ducks to turn your regular rubber ducky into a rubber ducky duct ducky. No, he makes ducts that you can convert your regular quad into a Cinewhoop. So buy them so that he can eat. FPV Cycles, who we're talking about here with TP3 that made me think of it. Lots and lots and lots of awesome stuff on Kebab Store. Get your ass over there and get some cool stuff, or else. Newbie Drone has also been a super duper friend of the channel. They're doing some awesome stuff. Support them if you can. I mean, just support them even if you can't. I don't know how that works. FPV Geek is maybe sending us some more giveaway prizes. This is Rondelios. He makes Just a Switch, JAS. If you've ever wanted a switch on your Fat Sharks, which I know you do, even if you haven't admitted it to yourself, you should get Just a Switch. Pyro Drone and Race Day Quads both sell it. If you search for JAS, which stands for Just a Switch. yeah, do it. Or else. And then Super Deluxe. Keep sending me stickers, so I keep showing them on the stream. Somebody stop me. It's a quote from a Ace Ventura movie, isn't it? No, it's not. No, it's not. Is it from The Mask? Somebody stop me. TP3 is, of course, from FPV Cycle. Get on over there and show them some love. So, here we go. There's a wheel. I hit that button. I hit this button. I get the goat ready. And... who's it gonna be? We won't know until it stops because there's so many people on this wheel that it can just show us colors. It's white. Who's white? Alvaro Felix is white. I have not seen that name before. Alvaro, you might be new. You've won. I'm gonna message you on Patreon to let you know that you won a TP3 frame. Congrats, man. The other cool thing about Patreon is it only lets you get in there once, so somebody with $1 million can't just come in and run the train on the chat. Next up! Like you guys can do in the Super Chat giveaway coming up soon, coming up next. Just gotta try shit sometimes. This is an Armaton Tadpole that was sent over to us. Why do I keep throwing away shipping envelopes that people ship cool stuff to me in? God damn it!
Was it Eric Farmer that sent this?
I think it was. I think it was Eric Farmer that sent us this Armaton Tadpole. I'm gonna look it up because it's just no good to not. It's just no good to always be throwing away your shipping containers that you use to remember people's names, but then when you're in a manic cleaning frenzy, you throw it away like a dum-dum. Pretty sure it was Eric, though. Come on. It was it? I'm looking. It was somebody. Ooh. I know how I'll find it. What's this called? The tadpole? Tadpole. Search. Pretty sure it was Eric. Yay! It was Eric. Look at me remembering things. If you can't pat yourself on the back, then nobody else is gonna. Huge shout out to Eric Farmer. Everybody show the man some love for sending over an Armaton Tadpole for us to do on the giveaways here. Let's see. Who's gonna get it? Oh, I forgot to do proof of life on the Tiny Whoop tier. Here you go. If you want to... Oh, great. Keystrokes are down again. Thanks, OBS. I'm in OBS, and it won't even let me... Oh, I'm hitting... Ah, there we go. User error. Here's all the people that were entered in the Tiny Whoop giveaway. You guys can rewind. I cannot. So I'm just going to show this quick. If you want to check, you can rewind and check. And there you go. That's everybody. Next up, we've got the Armaton Tadpole 3-inch microbrushless giveaway. Here is your proof of life. One page and two pages. And now we shall spin Zivil! I think it's going to be Jay Stoller. Nope, not even close. Daniel Sarmiento wins the tadpole frame. For the record, I did randomize this time. I did randomize. The wheel is random, but I also randomized the people's names. So for anyone doubting the wheel, it's wheeldecide.com. Do your own research if you want. I've tried to catch the wheel lying because the wheel has done some strange things. But I've checked the wheel multiple times, and it seems pretty goddamn random to me. I don't know. Congrats, Daniel. I'm going to put this aside. Oh, wait. Hey, look at me. I got a bag. Look, I got a... Look. This way I can keep them together. Oh, wait. No, I got to write people's names down, too. Hold on. Holy crap. I remembered eventually all the things. What's today? June 29th? Six. It's the sixth month. Two. Myself. Subject. 6. 29 giveaways. Body. Daniel Sarmiento. Tadpole. Not tadpole. Tadpole. There we go. And then the TP3 was Alvaro Felix. TP3. All right. And now we do... Yeah, the keystrokes are down. Or the hotkeys, rather, are down. Oh, no, they're working. Look at that. Hey! So now we're going to do the X-Hover frame. This is a Vanover race frame. I've got one of these that's about half-built with 2206s and a run cam hybrid. I can't wait to magically find the time to finish it. But everything else keeps breaking, and doing a scratch build when you've got a perfectly good build that's broken just always seems insane to me, so I just don't do it. So let's see who wins the X-Hover frame. It's going to be someone in this wheel here. Here's your proof of entry. Hopefully nothing exciting is going on in the chat because I haven't looked at it in about 10 minutes. There you go, and there you go. That's everybody on this wheel. Rewind if you want to check. If not... Who shall it be? I think it's going to be my dad, and I'm going to re-roll it. Let's see if I'm right. Nope! Free Lojo wins! Free Lojo, congratulations. You got yourself an X-Hover Vanover frame. You are a special person, and I want to rub your bald head. Do you have a bald head, Free Lojo? If you do, I don't want to rub it. Nothing personal, but, you know. Tweet. Did you say yes? Are we good to go? I don't know why we wouldn't be. I feel like you would tell me if we wouldn't be, but I think it's polite to ask, right? I didn't see that he said yes, but I'm just gonna assume. So here's how it works now. Super chat giveaways for anybody that for whatever reason doesn't want to join my Patreon page. No, I'm just kidding. We do a super chat giveaway where I set a dollar amount. Let's say let's go with $4 tonight. If you do a super chat for $4, son of a bitch, I'm on the wrong camera. If you do a super chat for $4, I will put you on the next wheel. If you do a super chat for $8, that's 7, that's 8, I'll put you on the wheel twice. $12, 3 times. $16, 4 times. Ooh, thank you, Frank. Good call. I would have remembered eventually. Free Low Joe. And that is the Vanover frame. Yeah, buddy. Okay, so yeah, $4 gets you entered. What you're going to win is a set of Tweet FPV. Transmitter grips. Which look a little like that. They are made of skateboard grip tape material. This is the super secret Ciati FPV purple and red custom ones. You don't have to get these if you're a boring layabout. You can just get black. But you know you want to get these. You know this is what you want. Look at that. Look at that shininess. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I got a new light set up here. That'll give us even more shinies. Ooh, look at that. Come on. If you don't get that, you're dead inside. Just kidding. You just like black better than purple. Maybe you don't like Barney. That's okay. That's all right. You're allowed to not like Barney. Oh my God, Remy Tim is getting 5 entries. He wants it. In addition to the Tweet FPV grips that you're gonna get, here's a bag of Avan Biblade props that just make the most delicious noise ever. There's a shitload of them in here too. I think there's like 5 bags in there. This is a bunch of race wires. Tiny's LEDs is another friend of the channel. They sent over a ton of race wires to use for these giveaways. These particular race wires here are some of my personal race wires. These are kind of cool. These are the OG, so you're getting a piece of history here. This is version 1 of the race wire LEDs. So basically what initially happened is he made race wires. This is a race wire. This is the full-length OG race wire. And then when everybody said, dude, you should make LEDs that go on those, he did, but instead of making a whole separate board, he made a little piggyback thing that you can solder on top of the existing race wire, which is kind of cool and interesting. So that's what you're getting. It's actually a dual, it's 2 separate pieces so that you can remove it. I don't know why you ever would. If you didn't want the LEDs, you could just black electrical tape over them. But hey, they work. And look, I even left the leads on there for you guys. You can check out some of my ugly-ass soldering. Yeah, so it's a full kit with like an extra bottom and just a bunch of random stuff that I've thrown in there for you that's race wire related. So yeah, there you go. Bag of those. And then the main attraction. 6 blade, 5-inch props. Flying in a Braille, it's $4. 2 more bucks and I'll get you on the wheel. If I don't see the super chats just explode, since I just showed you the main attraction, then I understand. Because in reality, who the hell wants 6-bladed 5-inch props? You should! You and you! You should all want these weird-ass props. Look at these things. Come on. Come on, man. Come on. Just, I know you want to seem like a serious pilot. I get it. But when nobody's looking, you can't tell me that you're not going to put this on your 5-inch rig and just blow all your ESCs up. You can't tell me that you're not. Look at that. Look. 1, two, three, four, five, six. Six. And I'm only sending you one bag because you're not gonna crash. And if you do crash with them, then you're just gonna be like, meh. If I do only send you one bag and you crash before getting to fly them, just message me and I'll send you a replacement prop. But yeah, you don't need two bags. They're not that insane. But it's an experience. It's a real experience, guys. Put a throttle cut on if you don't want to blow your shit up, because they're very, very inefficient. But Tom says, I will never let anyone see me fly those props. No, Rob, I bought these specifically for the giveaways. I've pretty much completely run out of like desk drawer cleaning stuff. Everything in these giveaways I've specifically bought for the giveaways. So yeah, I purposefully spent money on these specifically to try to hawk to you guys. To be really honest, I was just too curious. I had to know. And I figured if I have to know, some of you guys are going to have to know as well. So I thought, you know, it was Solo's doing a super chat for Krunked. No, Krunked already won. Solo, I'm putting your ass on the wheel. Krunked already has a set of these on the way. So nobody... he won't win, it's true. Nobody try to get Krunked to win these because he doesn't want them. But he is, I am forcibly sending him a set so that he has to test them. All right, let's put people on the wheel. It's 10:59. We'll get this super chat thing. So you guys got 60 more seconds to get in on the super chat thing. When I get done adding everybody to the wheel, I'm going to spin it and we're going to move on. And from 11 to 12 o'clock, we're going to do real valuable stuff instead of dicking around with six-bladed props. So I'm gonna put these here. I'm gonna scroll up. I'm gonna start typing, and when I'm done typing, someone wins props that they don't want. Jesus. All right, Daniel Maurer goes on first. He really wants useless props. If he wins, I'm gonna send him two sets, and we're gonna browbeat him into flying them all until they're broken. So here we go. It's 11 o'clock, my machine learning computer just said to me. So let's do it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Look at that. Look at that swagger. Rob Axelson with $4.99. He's in, and he even donated an extra dollar just because he loves me that much. Appreciate it, Rob. Metal Dirtskin, he really wants useless props. He's getting on the wheel three. What did I say? $4, right? Yeah, he's getting on the wheel three times. 1, 2, 3. Eric Allen wants to give away more money and not win anything. That comment guarantees that he wins. And he's going on the wheel twice. Flying in Braille with $2. I think I saw somebody else send another $2, so I'm going to put Flying in Braille on the wheel once. And big bucks, no whammies, and stop. Flying in Braille with another $2. I typed $4. That was weird, he says. Okay. Oh, yeah, Eric Allen did send. I almost forgot, but not quite. Did send another $2 for the decased GoPro fund. There we are. We're up to 6. Hey! Thank you for that, Eric Allen. EuroFPV with $2. I think he was adding to Flying in Braille. So now EuroFPV has to send $2 more to get put on the wheel. Love Drummer's getting on there three times. Tom from MySpace is here. He's joined us. Love Drummer. 1, 2, 3. All right, you're on there. Tom from MySpace is here. I will never let anyone see me fly this props. I don't blame you for 1 second, Tom. You and I, man, we're serious FPV pilots. We don't fuck around with this six-bladed nonsense. Solo FPV for Krunked, but I call shenanigans on that, and I'm putting Solo on the wheel, whether he likes it or not. Euro, I'm just going to put you on the wheel, because... Oh, my God, okay. Maybe there is more from... Jesus, okay. All right, 30 seconds from now, this ends. No more for Krunked. Shane, you're going on the wheel too. Frank Nicholas is going on the wheel 5 times. He wants to compete with the rimmiest of Tims and not let our fearless moderator, Daniel Maurer, win. All right, now there is now symmetry to the wheel. I like it. Shane Duggar with $4 for Crunks, but I call shenanigans. And I'm putting Shane Duggar on the wheel so that he wins props that he doesn't want. But there are grips that he will want, so it's all good. Oh, boy. No, Remy Tim. Remy Tim's broke, but he wants to break Crunked. But unfortunately, I will not let that happen. I'm putting Remy Tim on the board again. Kind FPV with a very kind gesture, a $20 super chat. Sorry, been MIA, moving across the country, back to Tennessee. FPV love, my brother. Dude, Kind FPV, awesome. You are going on the wheel 5 effing times. And I'm going to screw over Remy Tim by not adding his sixth entry to his other entries on top. Watch, this one's going to win. Kind FPV once, twice, 3 times, 4 times, and 5 times on the wheel. Holy crap, you guys are insane. Marley Leppo with 20 Norwegian kroners. This is second 20 Norwegian. Is it really? How did I miss? Jeez. Marley, I won't let you guys change the dollar amount. That's so annoying. Marley, 20 kroner is, I think it's one entry, right? I'm assuming it's one entry, so I'm going to put you on the wheel twice. Alright. Man, you guys are coming through, supporting the collective. There's Euros, $2 extra. He's already on the wheel. William Barlow is going on the wheel once, and we are going to call it there. And damn, you guys are awesome. What did I just say? Damn, you guys are awesome. That was weird. I was reading and speaking at the same time. You guys are awesome. Let's do the thing in the place. Advanced options. And wheel diameter 1200. Yeah, right off axis. Crunk says, let me guess, I didn't win. Nope. But, alright, I do feel bad. We are putting Crunked on here. We're going to give him the most possible chances. That was your second one. I'll do what you guys said. Shane Duggar said for Crunked. All right, so we're putting Crunked on twice. No, but if he wins, he's not going to want any of this stuff. Crunked won last... All right, no, I'm not putting him on there because he specifically told me last week he didn't want any of this stuff. I'm going to leave him on there once because he won't win. He won't win with the one entry. So we're fine. We're fine. No, just the one. Just the one. Jesus Christ. We'll see. If the crunked entries win, we'll have a discussion. Okay, how about that? I'll do you guys that. Jesus. Here we go. You guys ready? You better be ready. Wait, no, I have to do this. Apply wheel changes. There we go. 3, 2, 1. Here it comes. It's going to be Crunked. Nope, he's already off on the other side of the wheel. It's Metal Dirtskin. Metal Dirtskin wins. He did 3 entries and he won. Ha! On the middle entry, too. Metal Dirtskin, congratulations. You get some stuff. You got to work for the stuff, though. You've got a message. Tweet FPV on either Instagram or Facebook. He has an Instagram. I don't... You can definitely message him on Instagram. He might still be in the chat here. Shoot him a message. Let him know what transmitter you have. Let him know that you won. And your first name, your last name, your email address for tracking, and your address. And he will send you out. He will cut you and then send you out. And what color you want? You better get purple. You better fucking get purple. And you got to do the same with me. Shoot me a message on Facebook. All you guys, feel free to shoot me messages with your problems, questions, well wishes, obscenities. Ciotti FPV on Facebook, Instagram, Patreon. And here on YouTube. Say hello. I'm a nice guy, I promise. I don't insult you in person. I just insult you guys when you're not directly talking at me because it feels better that way. Metal Dirtskin wins. Congratulations. Let me know what you won. The Biblade props, the Six-Blade props, the OG race wires, and that's it. Congrats, brother. I'm gonna just really quickly put you on here. Metal, dirt, skin, OG, race, wire, biblade, Emacs, yellow, and six blade. It is 11:07. That might be the fastest we've ever gotten through the giveaways, or maybe it's not. I don't pay much attention because I'm just laughing and being a lunatic the whole time. You guys rule. Hey, I just emailed myself. Look at that. I just the email noise went off and I was like, ooh, somebody emailed me. Yeah. Yeah. That's your boy. Just karate kick a bird in the fucking face. All right, I'm going to scroll back up. Maybe. Yes, YouTube did not delete a bunch of comments. Thank you, YouTube. Love Drummer. Recommendations for, asks, recommendation for an AIO flight controller for a 3-inch 2S build. Love Drummer, you've asked me out at a good time. So there's this HMU LMNOP AIO board that Pyrodrone was the first one to sell, but we like to support the upcomers, so we're going to go to FPV Cycle and look at it. If you go to, and I think you can now get this board elsewhere, but you shouldn't. You should buy it from FPV Cycle. JHEMCU is who this board is made by. It is incredibly inexpensive, and Kebab and a bunch of the other Cinesplore testers have been running this on 2203s, and it's been completely fine. So I'm going to start buying these. This is the only toothpick board I'm going to buy moving forward because a bunch of people are saying that it doesn't catch on fire. And the layout is fine, and I have one here that I haven't used yet because I was all skeptical to use it, but apparently these are the shit, so I mean, for $37.50, it's kind of like, if it explodes, it's not that big a deal. Some of these other AIO, I've seen it like, I saw an AIO board for like $70. Like, no, $37, yes, $37. So yeah, JHEMCU, this is apparently what you want. Here comes a link into the chat. Buy it from Bob, and I'll shake your hand if I ever meet you. What do we got? Ruby Tim, oh shit, is it Monday night already again? How did I join the stream and not know what day of the week it was? My life is fucked right now. Kristen Sked said earlier today that she woke up today and had no, for the first time ever, had happy year of streaming. Thank you, brother. It's been, I think it's been like a year and a month or so-ish. Carbon Cage just got GoPro insurance in ounces for $75 Australian dues, full accidental theft and loss. Wow, theft. So you can just straight up wait a month and be like, yo, my shit got stolen, send me another one. I mean, I'm not telling you to do it. I'm just saying that I guess you could. Don't do that. I'm sure you wouldn't do that, but damn, that's crazy to carry. It's insane to me anytime anyone covers theft. Although I guess if they just say like, oh, you gotta get a police report, then at least you're lying to the police and they can just beat you to death. Sorry, too soon. Too soon. Isa, I always have trouble with it. Isa does it. Flies Tiny Hawk Race 2. What would be the tier for your Patreon for me? That would be the $5 tier. Tiny Hawk Race 2 would fit within the toothpick category. The motors that I've given away on that tier have been 1202s and 1202.5s. That would be a great motor to replace the 1103s on the Tiny Hawk Race 2 with if Emacs hadn't made the fucking bolt hole pattern proprietary. But the Race 2 is the best of the Tiny Hawks, in my opinion. The 1103s on there work really well with the 2-inch props, so there's really no reason. But, yeah, you would want to be on the $5 Tiny Hawk and, not Tiny Hawk, Tiny Whoop, and toothpick tier. I couldn't think of the word toothpick. Scrolling. Hey, there's Marley Lepo's 20 Norwegian Kroners. Thank you for that. Very kind of you. As usual, since Marlalepo is a very common super chatter, because she's a cool person, likes to support other gangly people. Yo Man Flight says, this band rocks, man. I forgot their name. Shane, what's that song and band? Sounds like Yo Man Flights wants to know. Mark Kunoff says, Stadium Dives? Oh, damn. Oh, yeah. Hawk Pro on 5S. Where's that? Do they make a Hawk Pro? Oh, right. 5-inch. Right. That's what I was gonna say, man. That thing is boogie, and I thought it was a micro. Off Axis says Shane needs some Loctite. Loctite all the things. Seth McLean says, oh, cool. Answered the same question. Five posts up. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Scrolling, scrolling, scrolling. Tweet FPV saying what's up, and then he leaves. Off Axis says, I want stickers. What stickers do you want? I have lots. Message me. Rob Axison says, I want stickers. There's gonna be a cool little thing coming. Just give it. I think they're gonna be here like tomorrow. They're gonna be here this week. So by the end of this week, there'll be a cool sticker related thing that you guys can get in on, and it's gonna be cooler than you ever thought it could be. Get your $10 ready. Jafar says, check out Kip Magal Alligator Swap Monster sometime. You're gonna love that song. I'm just gonna type it in right now and love it right now. What do you think of that? YouTube, feed me a song. Come on, go faster. Alligator Swamp Monster, here comes. Copyright strikes incoming. Here we go. So you might think I'm lying, you can feel it on my skin. Gets rough and scaly soon as you walk in. So was a time felt like an alligator swamp monster. And you can tell your friends that I'm being kind of rude, but I love to hear the sound of the dog closing after you. That sounds like oh, I can't think of the song that sounds just like. Oh God, it sounds just like one of Jack White's songs. Did I hear a kitten?
I did. Hi, buddy. How are you? You're getting stuck to the carpet. That means I need to trim your nails.
Let's see if I can get them. Hold on. Just gotta pretend like I'm not gonna go grab them. All right, ready? I'm gonna sneak attack.
Saw me, and he's gone. Worth a shot.
All right, swamp monster, you Kip MacLear bastard, alligator swamp monster. Look at that. That is, I'm into that song. I'm down. All right, killing the swamp monster. Where were we at? Five posts up. That's what's up. Alligator swamp monster. The mask, bro, says the Bandalorian. What mask? What mask? It was from The Mask. Yeah, that quote that I mentioned. It was from The Mask. That's right. You guys got me thinking about The Mask last week. Now I'm quoting it. Eric Farmer says it was me. I knew it. I did figure it out. All right. Hey, and then there's the there are the super chats. So holy hell, we are somewhat caught up. Oh, it's funny. Metal Driskin says, even if I don't win those, I would love to get some from you so I can cut them down for my Cinewhoop. It's fucking kismet, bro. I'm gonna send you two. If you're actually gonna use them for something, I'll send you two sets. Although, wait, no, you don't need two sets because Cinewhoops don't break props, right? If you break one of them, message me. I'll probably have some more, and I'll send you another couple. But I don't think you're ever gonna have to worry about them breaking because they're gonna be all ducted and cozy and protected and all that good stuff. Yo Man Flight says, let me get just one. One what? Tiago Remo says, I know the next project uses 6-blade 5-inch props with ducts. What? I know the next project uses the 6-blade 5-inch props with ducts. These are very OG Droney Droid. These are made by Racecraft, who I don't even think they make props anymore. But they used to make really decent props that were really well balanced. Yeah, nice art project, says Mark Kunoff. Rabox says, maybe with a 50-amp ESC. I flew them on an AK-32, and I just didn't pour, like, I didn't just hold full throttle for 10 seconds straight, and they were completely fine. I did a bunch of throttle blips, and I went to the moon, and then eventually I came home. Mark Kunoff says, I'll send you a bunch of props. Done. You send them, I'll give them away. Droney Droid says, with a pair of cutters and a little balancing, you can make three-bladed props. Well, that's true. We could chop every other blade off and have a somewhat useful prop. Screw that, though. We want six blades, goddammit. Seth McLean says, where do we get six-bladed props? Seth, you can't, because I bought them all. if you search for... So they're a 50-40. It's a 40 pitch. If you search for Racecraft with a K, R-A-C... I think it's R-A-C-E-K-R-A-F-T, six-bladed prop. I think you can find them somewhere. Wherever I found them, I bought all of them that they had, which wasn't much. It was like, I don't know, like 10 sets or so. Yeah, you can probably find them. I'm pretty sure I didn't buy them from the last store ever. But yeah, they're made by Racecraft. They're a 50-40, and they're a six-blade. If you really can't find them and you're really desperate for them, just message me and I'll send you a bag. If you pay for shipping, and because yeah, I don't want to feel like I legitimately, like, I made sure I wasn't legitimately buying the rest of them to just fuck off with them and send them out to people that don't necessarily want them. But you all want them, whether or not you know it, you want them, because it's a six-bladed prop, god damn it. And if you show, I promise you, if you show up to the next flight day with other people and you've got six-bladed props on your rig, I promise you, people will come over to you and be like, what's up, dude? What's going on there? And they're going to look at you just like that, because they're going to be like, what the fuck? This motherfucker showing up to a field to actually fly with six-blade? This guy's crazy. And, like, they probably won't turn their back on you, because they're going to, like, you know, think you're going to murder them. But that's okay. Rob Axison says, Oscar wants a set. Who's Oscar? Seth McLean says, where do we... Okay, we took care of that one. Scroll, 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 scroll. Rob Axison, the 99 cents is because I can't change the dollar amount. Thank you, YouTube. Tom says, whoa, I am from MySpace. Shane Decker says, no, Crunk needs an extra set. KindFBB says, no prizes for bro. I don't know what that means. No prizes for bro. Prizes for bro. I don't know what that means. Remy Tim says, I'm going to unsub from your Patreon if you don't give that one to Crunked. I'm glad that I did give it to him, because I didn't read that until just now. Frank Nicholas says, the other was just a chat. I don't know what that means either. This is the problem with being so far behind on chat, is like, at the time, I'm sure all these comments made sense, but I can't think back to what we were talking about at the time. Alfaxis says, great way to catch up on chat. I remember reading that one. Kind of, if he says, just showing some FPV love. Well, then I'm glad you didn't win. It worked out perfectly. Hermie Tim, in all capitals, Krunked has three entries. No, he does not. Alfaxis tagged me without saying anything. Or maybe he had like a link in there. Although, no, you should be able to post links off Axis. Rob Axison says, oh, he had to go. Bye bye, Rob. You're probably not here anymore. Be nice to each other. All right. And YouTube did the thing, so now I'm scrolling back up again. Oh, Dead South is the band. Okay, there we go. Straight from Shane. Dead South is the band. Off Axis says, your stickers. I think he wants my stickers. Soon. Soon. My god, YouTube, you scrolled me really far down, you motherfucker. I'll find it eventually. Hey, there it is. Eric Allen said, did you get my Facebook message? Probably, but I'm really behind. Don't forget to buy that URL. I can get it if you can't right now. Just get me back whenever. All right, so it sounds like there's something that might sell out. So let me get into my comments real quick. Where are you at, Eric? Where are you at? Where are you at? There you are. There you are, Eric. Would you... Oh! Flying session. Wait, what? Did you get my message yesterday about the flying session? Just making sure I sent it to the right person. I don't think I did. Let me do this, though. Let me go over to my Ciati FPV on Facebook page, which you should all be following. If you're not, then you're dead to me. And I'm gonna find out where you live and chainsaw your head off. Here it comes. Come on, Facebook. You can do it. You can do it, you slow son of a bitch. Here it is. Oh, yeah, there's the reminder. Okay, cool. Facebook message. Don't forget to. Oh, yeah, I gotta buy. Right. Fuck, you're right. What's the. What's the website where you can check if a. Oh, fuck it. No, I'm just gonna go to. It's the website that everybody gets websites from. Go daddy, go daddy, go daddy, go daddy, go mommy. Oh, guys, okay. No more super chats for me because we need to do something. We need the collective to work on something here. I think I just changed the thing. Yeah, this poor soul, James Benson, is getting fucked in Louisiana by an asshole neighbor and an asshole judge at his little town hall bullshit. This dude is just getting super duper fucked, and if you have a couple extra dollars, myself included, I'm gonna send him $20 because it's just not cool. This dude's little local town is about to get the shit whooped out of him for being jerk offs. And it's going to be because of us. So it looks like he's trying to get to 12 grand, and so help me God, I will not stop until he gets there because this is just not cool. He was flying. This asshole neighbor of his that's a cop decides to write him a ticket for just like trespassing or some horse shit. And then this cop somehow managed to convince the local judicial system to make, I'm not fucking kidding, to make a law saying that flying drones is it, he talks about it in here, and Joshua talked about it. Yeah, made a law to make flying illegal, which you can't do, of course, we all know that, but local government is, and as we've gotten to see through the BLM movement and everything that's been going on in the past month or so, cops, you know, they'll just make shit up sometimes. Not all the times. Not all cops are bad. Don't, I swear to God, if one of you fuckers types ACAB for all cops are bad, I'm gonna attack you with a shovel. All cops are not bad. Some cops are totally fine. Some cops are bad, though. And unfortunately, it sucks, but the good cops have to do the hard thing and rat out the bad cops because bad cops do shit like kill people. They're innocent. And that's not cool. Like, if there's anything in the world that you can't do, it's just kill innocent people. And unfortunately, nowadays, as a cop in America, you can just kill innocent people and then somehow manage to get away with it. This isn't quite that serious, but this is a very obvious case of police and whatever local judicial system, unbelievable overstep, and it's just not fucking cool, man. Like, it's bad enough that we have to deal with the FAA if we have to then also deal with some shitball cop, you know, getting a vendetta against us and trying to fuck us over when we were doing something completely legal. Not cool. Not cool. So we're gonna support what's his name? James Benson as much as we can, because if nothing else, we need this as like a case study to use words of the business world of like, hey, you guys can't do that. Like, we need him to get a lawyer and sue the shit out of the state of Louisiana so that this is so that there's something that says like, hey, if somebody tries to do it to one of us, so that we can at least be like, hey, look, if you want to do this to me, here's going to be the end result because I'm tied into X, Y, and Z, and our community does not put up with this bullshit. So yeah. If you've got some extra bucks to spare, please do help James Benson out because when shit like this happens once, it becomes okay. And then it starts happening more and more and more, and then it gets out of control. So, yeah, we need to take care of this now. I opened this up in the middle of Joshua's stream as soon as he mentioned it. I'm going to refresh it, and I want to see what that 3677 has changed to. Ready? Damn it. I was hoping to be a lot higher than that. So, hey, look at Daniel Maurer getting in. Keith B. Jones getting in. Look at you guys getting e-famous as hell. So, yeah, guys, I know it. Yeah, we just need to do it. There's the link again. Donate a couple bucks, at least donate something. If we can get the number of donors up to a billion, it all sends a signal of like, don't fuck with us, you jerks. All right, moving on. No, I gotta go to, hold on, gotta go to GoFundMe. Not GoFundMe, GoDaddy. And am I not logged in? Why am I not logged in? Sign in. No, don't make me put, I don't know what my password is. I'm going to email myself. I can't forget. I will forget if I don't do something. Email. Emailing myself. New message to myself. Domain. Done. Thank you for the reminder, sir. Off Axis says, karate kick a bird in the effing face. I know I already read it once, but I love it. KD2RDH Larry, I tried to get fancy and ordered color switch nuts for my TX Ruddy. I know exactly where you're going with this, Larry, because I did the same goddamn thing. And ordered color switch nuts for my transmitter from RDQ. The little tool doesn't fit the new nuts, nor the nuts on my TX16S. I thought you were going to say you had a QX7. Is this a common problem? Yeah. RDQ and there's one other place that sells the fancy anodized switch nuts, and I think in the description it says that they work on a QX7. They do not. They kind of work, but they don't really work. You could put them on, like you can get them all on. You don't need the tool. The tool doesn't work, so you have to get them on by hand, and it's a real pain in the ass, but eventually when you do get them onto the QX7, the switches don't get to their endpoints anymore. So the problem is that you flip the switch and the switch hits the metal switch nut, and I just don't get the feeling that that's really good for the switch. Plus, like, not having that last click is just weird. So I took them off and threw them away. But yeah, for the record, if you have a QX7, I do not recommend you get the fancy colored switches. Just take yours and take a paint marker. Yeah, that was a sad day for me as well, Larry. You know what it was? It was the day where I was like, you deserve this. You spent $8 on these, you sack of shit. You deserve for these to not work because you didn't need to buy these, you idiot. You should have taken Kristen out for lunch today instead. Yeah, so. Mark Kunoff says, Gemchu, is that how you pronounce it? I am never going to made by when Pyro started carrying them. First one had a bad ESC. Great. But the replacement has been awesome. That is actually the first I've heard of the Element OP AIOs being bad. So they're not invincible, but they still seem to have a pretty good track record. Eric Allen says, what the fuck happened? I have no idea. Offaxis says, haha, oh. Oh, you guys lost the stream? What the hell? Really? Is it working? We still here? I have zero dropped frames, so maybe it was just curvature of the earth. I don't know. Oh, yeah, right, over on the TBS lounge. It looks like Mr. Shady is giving us the dirt. It's been revealed that the Crossfire Micro V2... What the hell is the Crossfire Micro V2? Nano, micro... Is micro the is that what I have? just lagging a few seconds. Okay, cool. Is this a Crossfire Micro? It's definitely not a V2. I'm not going to take it off because the pins are a little weird. But I think, is this, maybe this is the Crossfire Micro, I don't know. But it sounds like if this is the Crossfire Micro, that they've got a V2, and it can run up to 500 milliwatts. I thought this could already do that. No, it was 100. It was 100 that it could go up to. And I think maybe 200. Well, that's pretty cool. It sucks there's going to be a V... Oh! So that would make sense, because these have been out of stock for a long time. So that makes sense. They stopped making it, and now they've been making the V2. That's pretty cool. That's really cool. Because my favorite thing about this module is that it's flat, right? And that, like, you just put your antenna in here. So this transmitter, for all intents and purposes, not intensive purposes, that doesn't make any sense. For all intents, I-N-T-E-N-T-S, learned something today, and purposes, this is not here. Like, this doesn't take up any space in the bag, which is why I love it. And, yeah, that's pretty cool. Maybe I'll buy a V2. 500 milliwatts is a lot of milliwatts. Although, it does really chew. I still run double A's because I have a million of these Eneloop low to no discharge double A's. And this thing up on whatever the hell its max power is really does eat through these. I would love to keep using these because I bought tons of them. Like, I'm talking like 40 or 50 of these for all of my off-camera strobes back when I was hot and heavy into photography. And I'm not hot and heavy into photography anymore, so it's really nice that I've been able to keep using these. That's pretty disgusting. Who knows where that's been? COVID! But, yeah, interesting. I haven't had any range issues with this on. I switched it to dynamic lately. But yeah, I haven't really had any range issues. I have had two fail safes, though. So in theory, I mean, they were both because I wasn't standing in a way that I should have been. I don't know. That's pretty cool. 500 milliwatts for something that's flat. Dope. Joe Kurtzall, my wife wanted you to know that she has no idea what you're talking about, but she sits with me every Monday and loves to watch you. Love it, Joe. What's your wife's name? I'll give her a shout out. Mrs. Kurtzall, you're a champion for loving Joe enough to deal with my fucking face for 2 hours. And just the absolute gibberish that comes out of my mouth. My wife, Kristen, says the same thing when I start actually talking technically. She's like, how the fuck do you know all those numbers? Like, she's like, sometimes you'll just say numbers for like 60 full seconds. I don't notice it. I mean, I don't know. Man brain, yo. We can spew numbers for hours and not get bored. Off-Axis FPV asked Joshua about picking the right milliamp hours for a custom build. He told me, just get a battery that's one-third the weight of the setup. Well, that's a really cool way of doing it. But is there a better way, like using maths or something? That's such a good way to do it. I never thought about that. It never even remotely crossed my mind to do that. But I'll bet you the batteries that I run are a third of what the quads weigh. Come on, get on there. No, that's not 140, is it? Wow, that's light. 140 and then 60 is what the 4S450s weigh. So it's pretty close. Yeah, that's pretty close. I'm a little under, because I'm willing to sacrifice flight time for flight performance. Damn, that's a really good way to do it. Yeah, a third of the all-up weight that you're shooting for. I would do it. I would do that, or maybe go a little bit lower, right? Because if you go a little bit lower, then you can fly less hard and still get good runtime, right? Damn. Yeah, there it is. A third of the all-up weight that you're shooting for. good way to buy batteries. Allfaxes says, your stickers, eventually I figured it out. Shane Duggar says, Dead South is the band, eventually I figured that out. Kind FPV says, I'd like some Slaps stickers, please. Get your $10 ready, Kind FPV, because they're coming. I'm not going to tell you anything else. Cage the Elephant, that's what, no, White Stripes, that's what I was thinking at the time. Mark Kunoff says, J-H-E-M-C-U equals Gem Chew. I will never call them Gem Chew, and I will always call them LMNOP. Just because I'm a jerk. Off-Axis says, I'll take one set, Cinesquirt. You message me. HQ did also make six-blade props, and you guys can see them. I took them off. They're in the prop box now. I'm not giving those away. I was only able to find one set of the HQs, and I'm a completionist. I like to have one of everything, so I'm saving them. Kind of Fifi says, I have a ton of props I'll send you for giveaways. Hit me with an address. Kind of FPV, I don't know where to message you at. So if you can message me on Facebook, I will message you back with an address, or just type into the chat where I can message you at. Paulie Lee is here. What is up to you? Off-Axis wants six-blade folding props, and now I do too. God damn it, Off-Axis. We could probably put them on top of each other. We could probably put the three blades on top of each other because of the way that the hubs are, because of the way that that Dow made the hubs, they're perfectly flat. Here we go. Here's the bad ideas. This is how the bad ideas start. Oh yeah, that totally works. That's fine. Extra long screw extension of some sort and a nut. Oh yeah, done. Six blade Dow confirmed. All right, here we go. TX-V2 also has USB-C. That is... Krunk says, 250 milliwatts is far more than enough. No point. I think I'm kind of the same mind. Krunk says, WTF... Dude, get the 3800 MAS 2S battery. Why? Why would I get that? Oh, right. Dude, I've had a bunch of people who've had those batteries fail on them. And once or twice, it's caused fail-safes. So, I don't know. I do want one. Every time I place an order, I'm very tempted to get one of those big-ass 2Ss. But, I don't know, man. Journey Droid says, I hope you can change those AA's mid-flight. You almost have to. They're actually, they're 1800, I think they're 1800 milliamps, so they're not bad. What are they? What are you guys? Ooh, I'm getting shaky. I'm hungry. No, they're 1900. Get that. They're 1900 milliamps, and... They don't lose their charge like most other batteries do. Yeah, I've had shockingly good luck with these over the last 3 years. I've literally only ever used these Eneloop batteries for the last 3 years, and I usually get about a week out of them. If I fly every day, every other day, I'll get about a week out of them, and that's fine by me. I have two extra sets in my bag, so changing them is easy. And I have a million of them, and I have the chargers. So it's kind of like, yeah, work for me. It works for me. Maybe it'll work for you. Death machine right there, Jafar says. I hit the bottom of the chat, guys. Holy shit. Off-Axis can't stop laughing. Six-bladed Dow props. Confirmed. Folding props, LOL. Have you guys all seen the Dow folding props? They're actually really good. I haven't flown them yet, but every single person that's flown them says that they're great. Look at these floppy fuckers. Yeah, they're the only negative to them is that they're a 50 pitch, so they're a little pitchy. But yeah, they and you do have to assemble them. They do not come assembled. But when you're sitting on the couch watching a movie or something, you just sit there and fucking So yeah, check them out. Dow Folding Props. You know who sells them? Bob Ruge sells them on FPV Cycle. They might be sold out, though. They're sold out. Mailbag! Mailbag! Mailbag. I completely forgot until just now. Oh! Peletheus, speaking... Oh! Shouldn't have done that. Peletheus... This stream output's in such shit quality that you probably couldn't have seen it anyway. But Paletheus sent us some cool stuff for the giveaways. Look at this fancy fucking thing, man. Dude, so I guess I've just been buying FPV Cycle frames for a long time. This is like, the way that FPV Cycle packaged this is like just kind of beautiful. I mean... You're just going to rip it open anyway, but still, like, they just, I don't know, man, they packaged it really nice, like, they've got the M3x6 called out here, and then this says Stack Hardware on it so you can't get confused, and then some fancy orange knurled and then smooth standoffs. And then this says M3x10. Really? Oh! And then look at this. Custom cut UmaGrip. UmaGrip Light, even, in green. So, like, yeah, I was shocked at the little... Oh, this is the note that that Peletheus wrote me. Yeah, very cool. And he sent me some personal stuff that you guys aren't allowed to get. But, yeah, this is... somebody's going to win this. Somebody's going to get a frame that's... packaged really well, and it looks like a good frame. The cutouts seem to be of, like, not too crazy and not too deep to make it weak, and yeah, I don't know, it looks like a really decent frame, and it's called the Stark. I mean, if nothing else, it's got a cool name. But yeah, this is gonna be a giveaway coming up at some point. Somebody's gonna get a cool little Stark frame. And another shout out to FPV Crate for being awesome. They worked with me on the Tiny Trainer build, and it was super fun. This is what's really cool, though. And I did not know this. I'm a kind of like a closeted tactical knife guy. I got into tactical knives a little bit after Airsoft kind of ran its course for me. And by ran its course, I mean I drove it into the ground by being way too into it. But Peletheus apparently makes bally knives, and the full name, if you're in the know, you call them Bally's. The full name is Bally Song, and they are these knives that I'm sure you guys have seen before. You've probably just not heard them called Bally's before, or Bally Songs. But these are pretty nice looking, man. He makes them custom. I'm seeing some swedge grinds, I'm seeing some titanium. I'm seeing some really nice stuff here. This guy appears to have a right up here on the that's called a swedge grind, I believe, there on the top. And then he's got some cool stuff going on here on the blade. They look to be really nice. Some really nice looking leather sheaths for him. Here's another few there. Seeing some, this might be some colored G10. G10 is a plastic that knife makers use a lot. That's very, very strong. It's like a PTFE style plastic. And then there's some nice deep grooves cut out into these blades. Really, really nice looking stuff. I've seen a lot of custom tactical knives, so I have somewhat of an idea of what's going on. And a whole bunch of his stickers. Awesome little swag bag. So, Peletheus, thank you, brother. This is super, super, super cool. If you guys are into... if you guys want to get into Bally's, first and foremost, don't just buy one of these right away. Buy a trainer. If you're going to get into the Bally thing, even if you just want to own one, do yourself a favor and buy a trainer, because when you cut yourself with a Bally, you cut yourself... typically in places where there are tendons, and if you go through one of those tendons, you are not going to be happy about it. It is just not good. Butterfly knives, yeah, that's the other more common name for them, kind FPV. Butterfly knife, that name for them has kind of a negative connotation, so I know a lot of people call them Bally's now. But yeah, these look beautiful, and I'm very impressed by the workmanship that I can see just in these little pictures. And after the stream tonight, I'm actually going to hop on his website or whatever he's got going on. Actually, let me give him a shout out there. So it looks like on Instagram, he's at Paletheus, Paletheus. And then he's got a website, Paletheus Designs, Paletheusdesigns.com. Can a moderator please hook me up and throw a link to at Paletheus, Paletheus. And then his website is Paletheusdesigns.com. These look fucking beautiful. Very, very, very cool. I personally am not a Bally Song kind of guy. I have seen too many people gash themselves open on them. Like, I've seen people gash themselves open at gun... I used to go to a lot of gun shows to run a booth with a friend of mine who was into tactical gear, and it was a bunch of us that had been into airsoft for like 9-10 years at that point, so we knew a lot about tactical gear, even though, you know, none of us were ex-military or current military or anything like that. But yeah, way back when, I learned an awful lot. It's actually my first time coming to Atlanta. I went to a Blade show. There's a huge knife show called Blade here in Atlanta every year. And it was the first time I came down here. Came down to a Blade show, met a bunch of the guys from Strider and Emerson and all the other big tactical knife companies, because that's just what I do. I try to meet all the people that have already driven it into the ground so that I can drive things into the ground myself as soon as possible. Marley Leppo with 20 Norwegian kroner telling me to check my Facebook messages. Sent you the other six-bladed props. Awesome. Appreciate that, Marley. I can't believe you found them. I didn't really look too hard for the HQ ones, but that's cool that you found them, because the one time that I'd seen them is when I bought them. So you probably found them on an interesting website. Hey, there's Paletheus. Awesome. 2016, this is... I was back in the... In like the this would have... When did I go to Blade? Probably around 2006, maybe 7, maybe 8. Yeah, Paletheus, good shit, man. Very cool. If one of you guys is going to get... Oh, well, no, you'll just send him another. I'm going to sneak these in. I'm going to sneak these in to giveaways just to mess with people. But yeah, guys, please, 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 please get a trainer. Please get a trainer. They're like... $40, but it's going to be way cheaper than the hospital visit. And especially with Paletheus making custom ones, they're going to be dumb sharp. And like the difference between a regular Bally and like a custom one that's dumb sharp is real. Like, yeah, they're legit. All right, Frank Nichols says, focus, deal. they all get swerved, Paletheus says. Larry says, have you seen the Bally Song bottle openers? I have. I think they're cool, but I don't have any bottles to open. The bottle openers, a bunch of guys used to use those as their trainers, and I remember seeing trainers that had the bottle openers built into them. There we go. Paletheus says, I cut a tendon in my foot about 5 years ago, and then he put $4 signs. I'm sure it was... thousands of dollars. Any experience with the Sebastian Martinez asks, any experience with a massive droner frame from Catalyst Machine Works? Not personally, but Joshua Bardwell has had, I think he's had that massive droner frame for a while. All of Catalyst Machine Works are very durable, very well made and like well thought out, but they tend to be a little bit heavy. They're heavy because they're strong, though. So, I mean, it's the weight is there for a reason. So if that's what you want, if you want a really strong, really heavy frame, definite thumbs up. My take on frames is that you can be a little bit lighter. I prefer the way that lighter rigs feel, and I have found frames that are plenty strong but still light. So, yeah. It's not the frame for me. But if you want something that's stout as hell and is really cool looking, to be totally honest, they make great frames. Absolutely nothing bad to say about Catalyst Machine Works. Their frames are awesome. You just gotta find one off Axis. I don't even know. I've been out of the knife game for so long. I wouldn't even know where to tell you to find a trainer, but I'm sure Polathius can, because he's definitely in the game. Did I miss any chats? Can't stop laughing. Okay, good, good, good. Sweet, I think we're caught up. Gangster ass knives indeed. Look at that, we're caught up, and it's 11:53. What do you guys want to do for 7 minutes? I'm gonna end the stream on time. Oh, mailbag, right, mailbag. Okay, so there's our next 7 minutes. Hit me with the questions. You've got 7 minutes, and then I'll be back probably tomorrow, maybe Wednesday. Oh, really? Yeah, I remember back then the trainers were hard to get in touch, were hard to get your hands on. That's funny. Wow. Interesting. These are M2 5mm spacers, which I know are going to come in handy. Oh, AliExpress. Very cool. Thank you, Marley. Marley Leppo with another 20 kroners. Man, Marley. So yeah, M2 by 5 spacers, and these are M2 by 2 spacers. This order is from Pyrodrone. Pyrodrone is where you can get these. These are great for just it's just nice to have spacers like this when you're trying to fit like a stack that's perfect. Whoop Wednesdays, hell yeah, for sure. I got it. I'm not gonna forget. I might forget. I'm gonna try not to forget. Yeah, having M2 and M3 spacers of different thicknesses in your bag is really, really nice. Perfect kind of little things to order when you're doing an order already, and maybe you need to get over the $50 mark for free shipping or something like that. Stuff like this is so nice to have in your toolbox. I got these in a whole bunch of colors, blue and red and purple, just because, again, I need to have these in my toolbox. Oh, these are M2 by 15 standoffs. They look like M2 by 10s though. These are, I hope they're M2 by 15s. I'm gonna measure one right now. Nope, they're M2 by 10. God damn it. I might have clicked the wrong button. I meant to order M2 by 15s so I can put them in the back of the tiny trainer. The back of the tiny trainer has a little bit of extra space. The standoffs it comes with are M2 by 16s. I want to use that little bit of space by doing 15s in the back, and I'll just drop the back of the canopy down. It won't make any difference, but crazy like that. My favorite antenna of all, the TrueRC Singularity. And as I have recently learned, when prepping this, and all you need to do anymore to prep it is to put a little piece of shrink wrap over the top lobe. You want to use the rubbery shrink wrap. You don't want to use the hard plastic crinkly shrink wrap. Because the rubber shrink wrap is more durable in this application. So if you're going to get a TrueRC Singularity, which I recommend that you do, take a little piece of the rubbery shrink wrap that you've got laying around and put a piece of it over the lobe of this thing that's long enough to cover the whole thing. You want it to shrink wrap. There's a cap on the top here, and you don't want that cap popping off. So you want the shrink wrap to come down a little bit here and then come down a little bit on the back so it doesn't pull off. Where can you get that rubbery shrink wrap? Pretty much all, SB Man 80, pretty much all of the FPV shops sell it, or you can just go to like Amazon and type in shrink wrap. 99% of the shrink wrap that you're going to get is the rubbery shrink wrap. It's very rare to get the crinkly plastic stuff. This is the noise that the crinkly. Yeah. Sorry, guys. I'll try to remember to hold things up back here. But yeah, this is the crinkly plastic stuff that TBS sells. That's where I had to get it. It's good for a lot of applications, but it's just not good in this particular application. So, Ishii Nano, because I thought that I blew the one up. More of the little spacers. Ooh, what's this? What did I get here? Flywoo frame arm LED. Oh, yeah. Flywoo makes tiny little. Oh, I can do this.
Yes.
Flywoo makes tiny little LEDs for toothpicks, and they're like a dollar. I almost bought a ton of them, but just not gonna use them. This is a pretty cool little thing. Look at this. Pyrodrone XT60 LED. So you put this right next to your XT60, and it's got these little LEDs on it. I like LEDs. This is a little Beta FPV micro canopy that I'm wondering what the... Oh, too loud? Yeah, it is too loud. Because I'm sitting too close to the microphone. Let me move over. Alright. I have the mic gain turned up so that you guys can hear me when I'm over here. Oh, this is made of good plastic, boys! This is the ugliest of the Tiny Whoop frames. Let's just be honest. But... Wait. I don't know why off-axis. I have no idea why I bought the XT60 LED thing. This is that, like, really, really durable plastic that, yeah, this is going to be a really tough frame. This is, I'm glad that I got this. Man, is it ugly, but this will be nice to have floating around because of this plastic it's made of. Awesome. Way to go, Beta FPV. Thank you for making, finally making a canopy out of plastic that's not going to grenade the second that I smash it into something. What in the hell? This is a Tiny's LEDs 1-3S, little tiny 3-LED chip. I don't know why I bought that either, but I like LEDs. And then this is our search for the next best 20x20 small flight controller.
It's 12 o'clock.
It's 12 o'clock. This is the Hack RC, so if it blows up the second that I put power to it, I have only myself to blame for making something called Hack, or made by a company called Hack. Yeah, this is a little 20x20 30 amp, I think. I don't know. This is not the 20x20 ESC that I'm excited about. This is the iFlight $33, I think, 35 amp, 2-6S BL Heli 32 ESC. I think this is the one that we want, but I got this one just so that I could test the other new small light 20x20 ESC. This I am legitimately excited about because I'm going to run this head-to-head against this Singularity. This is TBS's little tiny unopenable antenna, UFL antenna, and the big thing I wanted to see was, okay, yeah, so it's always hard to get a feel for how big the anything is on the internet. Yeah, this is, well, and I can see that it still has a cap on the top here, so this is still smaller and lighter. So I know it doesn't seem like much. I'm not approaching the lightness of these from a saving weight on my rig standpoint. I'm approaching it from, I run these UFL antennas in a way that the cable gets held here and then it's just out in the wind to flop around on its own. And when it gets into crashes, it bounces all over the place. Here's the deal though. These Singularities are so goddamn lightweight that they just really survive well. They don't have enough mass to like bounce into the props, and for some reason they just have not been getting into the props. I'm leaving like this much exposed, which is, it gives them enough room to get into the props, but magically they don't, and I think it's because they're so lightweight. This guy, just because it's bigger, is gonna be heavier, so a little bit more chance for it to get in the props. See, look, you can see it. You can see what I'm talking about, right? See how much far, this one's got so much more mass, right? This is gonna much more easily bounce over into the props than this one. Yeah, look at that wiggle, man. Look at that difference in wiggle. Come on now, you can't tell me you don't want the less wiggly one. And it's red. Look at that. That is grade A product testing right there. You hold them and you flick them with your finger, and that tells you everything you need to know about them. All right, guys, that's it for me. I am really hungry now. I'm gonna go get some food. I had beans on toast before I streamed, but apparently I didn't eat enough. Ooh, we got some orange though. Here we go. Whoop Wednesdays, don't forget. I'll try not to. Tiago then says, check the Rush antennas. They're the same antenna, but the cap seems better. So the deal with the Rush antennas is they're made by TrueRC, but they have a second like outer layer on them, and I talked to Hugo at TrueRC about them, and he said that the Rush antennas are still really good, but they're not quite as good as the Singularity. So TrueRC has a cheaper version of the Singularity. That's what the Rush antennas are. They're like 12 or 13 bucks, and this is 20 bucks. He basically said, you get what you pay for. These Singularities are TrueRC's like top shelf premier antenna, and then the Rush and their cheaper ones are just not quite as good. They're still really good, as people that have used them know, but they're just not quite as good. And they're a little bit heavier. They're for sure heavier because they have the second layer. They have like an internal an inner plastic layer, and then they have another outer plastic layer. So that's gonna make them a little bit heavier, and that's what I'm afraid of, right? I love these so much because they're so scary light. So I'm gonna stick with these. Plus, I got that red and purple thing going on. So, although I think those red ones are, yeah, the Rush ones are red too. But yeah, I'm hell bent on these singularities. I just fucking love them. But all that being said, the Rush. Oh, you know what I really don't like about the Rush antennas? That's what it was. They have that like, it's like they put a forever tube on there, and I don't have a good way of mounting that. I have all of these mounts that these that this specific thickness of UFL wire snaps into the mount. Here it is. It's like, I have a whole bunch of these that I mount my antennas with. It's just a little TPU thing. These came with old Rotorius rigs. This 3D print file is probably long gone, but as you can see, or not, because I'm not holding it up to the camera, right? And now the camera's not focusing. But yeah, in this little tubule here, the UFL just pops in there, and then I shrink wrap over it to really grip it down. And the Rush antennas have that wacky forever tube, which is a great idea, but I don't know of any mounts that will hold that forever tube. And until I find one, yeah, it's all singularity all the time for me. Drain Droid says LED XT60 for disconnect in the dark. Ooh, there's a good reason for it. Sold. Thank you, Drain Droid. Flying Braille says I've got a Triumph Pro on two quads and love it. Is that what this is called? Triumph Pro? Look at that. Yeah, it is. Yeah, I'm sure this will work really good. But man, that wiggle, bro. Look at that wiggle. Look how wiggly. So if it stays out of the props, it'll be great. But look, man, it doesn't even wiggle. It's like that. I gotta do the rubber pencil thing with it, and I gotta like loosen my fingers up to even get it to wiggle. Whereas this one, I can just wiggle it all day. It's getting late. We're getting crazy. Sebastian says, any disadvantage to go with the stubby version of the Triumph Pro? Absolutely, Sebastian. How far an antenna hangs off the quad actually makes a really big difference. You've got a big ass LiPo battery in front of it, so when you flatten out and it disappears but behind the LiPo, you really lose signal. These things do not go through batteries worth a good goddamn. So it actually is pretty important to try to, if you want good range and if you want good video all the time, to get your antenna lobe as far away from the quad as possible. That when you make it, when you put the stubby ones on and they're really close, it's going to be a little bit more durable, but you're just going to suffer basically every time you turn back towards yourself and maybe like either pitch flat or pitch up a little bit, a stubby antenna is just going to really lose a bunch of reception for you. Off axis asking if I would look at that. If you don't know that joke, type it into YouTube. Tiago says, nice to know. Krunk says, I use Rush Cherry SMA and they are great. Yes, they are, because they're made by TrueRC and Hugo makes awesome antennas. We did it. I can wiggle it all day, guys. Look at that. Look at the difference. Look at the difference. CMYKFPV with the last question of the night. FR Sky versus Crossfire on a Taranis X9 Lite range difference? Big time. FR Sky is going to get you in perfect conditions out to about a mile. Crossfire will push 4 and 5 and 6 miles. That being said, I love FR Sky regular, what's the regular? 2.4, I guess. Yeah, I'm a big fan of regular FR Sky on small stuff, on micros. I don't fly micros really far away because micros go very slow and they would take forever to get far away and I would be very bored. So yeah, on micros, I keep regular old FR Sky 2.4, and it's plenty of range for a micro. And God damn it, I knew somebody was gonna ask it. Thank you, Droney Droid, for asking it and forcing me to do this because I should have weighed them. But yeah, 5-inch rigs, I am all crossfire all day. It's 5-inch rigs are much more dangerous, they're much more expensive, and yeah. 1.5 grams on the Singularity with some extra reinforcement from they've got two layers of black shrink wrap on there already versus realistically both of these are plenty light. 2 grams for the TBS. Half a gram difference in the grand scheme of a quad doesn't really make that much of a difference, but yeah, that wiggle though, I'm gonna hold them from as far down as I can. And we'll do the wiggle test one more time. We're gonna end the stream on the wiggle test. Meme me, bro. You won't. All right, guys. Remember, very important.
諦めんなよ。諦めんなお前。どうしてそこでやめるんだ、そこで。もう少し頑張ってみろよ。ダメダメダメダメ、諦めたら。周りのことを思えよ。応援してる人たちのことを思ってみろって。あともうちょっとのところなんだから。俺だってこのマイナス10度のところ、しじみが取れるって頑張ってんだよ。絶対するの。必ず目標達成できる。だからこそ言えばいいんだ。諦めんなよ。諦めんなお前。どうしてそこでやめるんだ、そこで。もう少し頑張ってみろよ。ダメダメダメダメ、諦めたら。周りのことを思えよ。応援してる人たちのことを思ってみろって。あともうちょっとのところなんだから。
All right, guys. If Clam Man won't let us give up, then we can't give up. that's Clam Man, by the way. Thanks for hanging. You guys are awesome. How many people are still left? Should we do a little send off? 36? Yeah, 36 people, that's plenty. Let's do a send off with a super secret video. Let me delve into my unreleased Patreon only, sometimes not even Patreon only because I've forgotten to post it over there. Videos. Yeah, click things if you'd like. If you don't, I'll attack you. You know the deal. Videos. And let's find something unreleased. Where could I find it? Just type Clam Man into you. It's YouTube. Believe it or not, I think that'll work. Clam Man. Here's a video called T-Motor F40 Pro 2 1750. I have no idea what this is, but we're about to watch it together. Here we go, guys. Get your seatbelts on. That's a stupid thing to say. I regret saying that. Thanks for hanging. Patreon FPV vendor list is a constant work in progress. If you guys know any, drop them in that thread and they'll be there forever. Thanks for hanging, guys. I'll see you tomorrow or Wednesday. Go fly, don't die, drive fast, take chances. Here's an unreleased video. Oh my God, guys, the Miata. Holy shit. This is. Wow. That car was only running for about 2 weeks last year before I ran it into something. God damn. A rare video. All right, I'll give you the audio back. In case anybody was wondering, that's what the Miata looks like when it's actually running. Now the whole front end is destroyed because I'm a idiot. All right, see you guys next week. Not next week, tomorrow or Wednesday. Disgusting. That was a rough one.